There's a miracle in this room with my name on it. There's a healing in this room, and it's here for me. Oh, there's a breakthrough in this room. It's got my name on it.
Can't sing anything. I have to keep this rusted knife I've been holding, waiting on somebody to come in my pocket. God says, what you have to understand before you open up your mouth and speak the thoughts that you have in desires in your mind, let me speak through you. Breathe. And then speak. See, sometimes before we breathe, we speak. And it's like my granddaddy say, it's like when you allow the toothpaste to come out the tube, you can't put it back in. It's too late then, because you already said something, and now you lost who you are. Your identity, your Christianity has now been removed, because a lot of times we use as an excuse, don't make me put my religion down. Where you gonna put it at? And how you gonna pick it back up? You either are or you are not. So before you lose who you are, lose your character, lose your integrity, lose the modicum of who you become, and the all the amount of day that God has created in you, first of all, you got to know, before I speak, let God speak to me. God said, what I'll do then, I'll speak through you, and I have the Holy Spirit to close your mouth, and I allow it to speak through you. So you'll say what I desire for you to say, and not say what you really want to say. Leave me alone, for I have to get ugly. It's too late. It's too late. So before you get to that point, ask God to speak through you, so you won't say the things that would disrupt who you are. They want the things that you don't really need to say, but you want to say them so bad. I need to go over there and get them told. What you gonna tell them? What you gonna tell them? I'm almost there. What we have to do is we have to know, because God is who God is. We can't call God a battle axe in a time of trouble when we're always hiding our own battles. We can't call a refuge in a time of storm, but when the storm comes, we find ourselves running from the storm. We can't say God is our all and God is our everything, but every time we think about what God has done for us, we find ourselves always fighting. God said, I'll fight your battles for you. Sometimes you got to trust God for his word. Keep your mouth shut. Keep your mind prayed up. Keep your hands to yourself. Like a little kid, put your hand in your pocket so you won't do something you will regret for the rest of your life. Hold your peace and let God work it out. I know it's back history, Mom. I know that. They give us 28 days and we're going to get 29 this year. But while that's going on, while that's transpiring, we have to reflect on where God has brought us from. And God did not bring us to a point where we now lose what God has given us. God brought us from a mighty long way. And how do we hold on? Because we got to hold on to our faith. Because we are still in wolf country. Don't fool yourself. If we want to get Barack Obama interviewing right now, then you correct that, President Barack Obama, because I don't like what the other folk call him otherwise. President Barack Obama. I'm going to say that again. I don't like what the other folk call him. That's why I ain't going to disrespect him like that. President Barack Hussein Obama. And what happens is, when the attack happens, He finds himself still being a sheep. Then he go get some clips. And what we have to understand through the attack, you still have to know that God has still declared you to be a sheep. But God said you got to listen to the voice of the shepherd. Who is the shepherd? David said the Lord is. And the sheep recognize and hear my voice.